We can start.
Good afternoon, everyone. Greetings from the Department of Nutrition and Dietetics, National Institute of Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation, Kalyetumkara. We at NIPMR extend our very warm welcome to all the dignitaries gathered here today for the inaugural function of the 30 Days International Online Workshop on Academic Writing and Communication Skills, Research Methodology, Reference Management, and Academic Publishing. NIPMR has jointly collaborated with Loran Ed Research Associates, MG University Kottayam, and 22 colleges across Kerala for this virtual workshop. I request the Director of Loran Ed Research Associates, Mr. Jindo Michael, to deliver the welcome speech.
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the National Institute of Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation, and Loran Ed Research Associates, I formally welcome you all to the inaugural function of the 30 Days Online Workshop on Academic Writing and Communication Skills, Research Methodology, Reference Management, and Academic Publication. With great pleasure and privilege, I welcome our chief guest for the day, Honorable Minister for Higher Education and Social Justice, Dr. R. Bindu. She has been an academician and has always shown keen interest in research. It is indeed an honor to have her amongst us today. The meeting's keynote speaker is none other than Professor Dr. Sabu Thomas, Vice Chancellor of Narmada University, Kottayam. Professor is a prominent scientist in the area of polymer science and engineering. I extend a cordial welcome to you.
Hello, excuse me. To the participants, kindly mute yourself, please.
NIPMR, a center of excellence in the field of disability management, is the primary collaborator of this workshop. I take this opportunity to extend a warm welcome to Sri Chandra Babu, the Executive Director of NIPMR, for this inaugural function. The workshop is the culmination of a rare meeting of 22 higher education institutions in Kerala with the goal of improving the quality of research. The association of these institutions' librarians have played a significant role in achieving this objective. Last but not the least, I would like to extend a hearty welcome to the principals and librarians of the collaborating institutions, as well as the faculty members, research scholars, and all well-wishers who have joined us to make this inaugural function dynamic and engaging. Thank you.
Devai, matte participants, ella avarude mute cheyano appirthikkunnu. Idakki cross talk varunnundu. Devai, ellarum mute cheyya. Avarku avasaram varumbol maatram samsarikkya.
Thank you, sir. Now I request the Executive Director of NIPMR, Mr. C. Chandra Babu, to deliver the presidential address.
Honorable Minister for Higher Education and Social Justice, Dr. R. Bindu, respected VC of the MD University, Dr. Thabu Thomas, and other dignitaries. NIPMR is organizing a 30-day workshop on international workshop on academic writing, communication skills, and research methodology, reference management, and academic publishing. In this regard, NIPMR is collaborating with Loran Ed Research Associates, St. Stephen's College, Udavur, Assumption College, Chengannacheri, Mahatma Gandhi University Library, Kottayam, St. Thomas College of Education, Pala, CMS College, Kottayam, and 18 other academic institutions across Kerala. I special mention that Mr. Lali Kesire, Principal and Stephens College, has taken the initiative in organizing this program. As we all know, so many research and writings are happening in Kerala, but these are not properly published to get the benefit of the general public in this regard. We are hesitant to publish these things. So it is necessary to have such an initiative to equip our academic personnel in this regard. In this regard, we need cooperation, collaboration, coordination of our research and writing activities. I am very happy that NAPMR could collaborate in this venture, and we will be taking this initiative forward. With these few words, I thank you all of you for participating in this program, and I invite Honorable Minister for Higher Education and Social Justice, Dr. R. Bindu, to inaugurate the program. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite our Honorable Minister of Higher Education and Social Justice, Dr. R. Bindu, to address the gathering.
Am I audible?
Yes,
ma'am. Respected dignitaries, resource persons, dear delegates and friends. At the very outset, let me congratulate NIPMR for organizing a very relevant and useful workshop on academic writing, communication skills, research methodology, reference management, and academic publishing. The history of evolution of human civilization is proof of the innumerable discoveries and inventions made by mankind. A curious mind is never bored. We are all born with an inherent nature to explore and discover the world around us. The inquisitiveness to do research, majority of the times, leads to the process of networking with similar minds and establishing the infrastructure and facilities required to do so. Globalization has been transforming the world. We can observe a paradigmatic shift, collapsing all sorts of boundaries existing between disciplinary categorizations. This is evident in the research circles as well. The techniques of collecting literature, data collection, data analysis, all have witnessed a mammoth change. Digitalization of processes, availability of research-specific software have all been a major factor in reducing the time and effort needed in data collection, analysis, review collection, etc. Actually, now we have a world without boundaries. Blurring of boundaries is what is happening around us. The input of improvements in technology in this aspect has made it such that rapidly increasing volumes of data are analyzed. Researchers are able to generate insights on previously untapped data and leverage this for better estimation and intuitive approaches to their decisions. Digital innovations are now making it such that communication is enabled among fellow researchers and organizations. With that, access to real-time data, subsequent updates, and effective analysis are made available to fill in data gaps. In this regard, one needs to stress upon the importance of publication of work done as well. Through publication, the researcher can disseminate the outputs to a larger segment of the society in a field that is developing at such a rapid pace. A workshop such as this would train professionals and students to stay abreast with these latest techniques. To become globally recognized, it is essential to be up to date with current research trends in the field. One should also possess good communication skills to spread the research findings to different platforms, which can lead to collaborative and interdisciplinary works. This 30-day online international workshop on academic writing and communication skills, research methodology, reference management, and academic publishing is a unique blend of theory and practical sessions and will involve in-depth discussions on the contents of research publication as well. Domain experts from reputed institutes all over India are the resource persons for this workshop. This will aid in empowering professionals and students in pursuing research and develop a research temperament. This is the vital need of the hour as far as Kerala society is concerned. This is a good initiative. This workshop is a good initiative taken by the NIPMR team, Lower Ended Research Associates, St. Stephen's College, Uraur, Assumption College, Changanasheri, Mahatma Gandhi University Library, Kottayam, St. Thomas College of Teacher Education, Pala, CMS College, Kottayam, and 18 other colleges across Kerala that have collaborated for this venture. Let this fervor of doing research continue and culminate in development of research culture, implementation of new research, and fruitful collaborations among institutions. Once again, I congratulate all the organizations and wish all the very best to the workshop. Thank you. With these words, I inaugurate the workshop.
Thank you, ma'am. I request the Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, Kottayam, Professor Dr. Sabo Thomas, to deliver the keynote address.
Very good morning to all of you. Respected Dr. Bindu, Honorable Minister of Higher Education and Social Justice, Government of Kerala, Sri Chandra Babu, Executive Director in charge of NIPMR, and all the respected colleagues, faculty members, students, librarians. Let me first congratulate National Institute of Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation in organizing a 30 days workshop on academic writing communication skills. And I'm glad, as a Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, I'm really excited today because you do this program in cooperation with, I think, more than 20 institutes, colleges, including my own university. My library is actively participating. As you all know, publication is extremely important. This is the way the knowledge is transmitted to society. You look at any ranking, either by NAC ranking or national ranking or international ranking, by Shanghai ranking or Times ranking or QS ranking, you will see that publications play a very important role. When you look at publications, I always tell my students, you'll have to publish in high ranking journals. I tell my students, you publish in high impact journals. That is very, very important. For chemistry, if you look at the high impact journals are from American Chemical Society, Royal Society of Chemistry, we have excellent chemistry journals. The quality of publication is very important. Second important thing I always tell them, don't publish in predatory journals. There are lots of companies now, they lure the students and faculty members and take money for publication. So never and ever publish in predatory journals. If you publish in predatory journals, you really kill the science. And third important point I want to tell you is, I see lots of cut and paste in publications. Dear friends, I'm the editor of Nanostructures and Nano Objects by Elsevier. Every month I get something like 100 research articles for publication. It's very sorry to tell you that more than 70% of these articles are plagiarized. As soon as I get an article, Wiley has given me a software. I run the article through software. I find that most of the articles are plagiarized. I immediately reject the articles. If it is less than 30% only, I will send out for review process. So my request to all my colleagues, students, faculty members, never plagiarize. Never copy and paste. I get a lot of theses to evaluate. And when I look at the introduction part of thesis, you will find that, I will find that most of the parts are plagiarized. So I request all the students, be extremely careful. And some work, we found that they even manipulate some of the data. Since I'm the editor of Nanostructures and Nano Objects, I don't want to name the exact person. We had a very leading researcher from Europe. And we know what he did. He manipulated some of his microscopic pictures and published in my journal. Even I couldn't find that. But after a couple of years, we found that this professor has manipulated some of his microscopy data and published in the journal. There are now agencies worldwide, they are vigilant about this sort of manipulation. And finally, he had to retract all this articles. So we have to be extremely truthful in scientific publishing. We have to publish a lot, that's very, very important, but we have to be truthful in scientific publications. Quality of publication is very important. And you have to really see the reproducibility of the publication. It's very important. If you do an experiment, if you get something interesting, see that whether you can reproduce that. I remember when I did a postdoc in North America, my advisor, Professor Robert Emery Proudhon, whenever I go and meet him with my data, he always checks everything. How many times you repeat the experiment? What are the statistical tools you have used? Dear friends, we have to use all the statistical tools when you get some data. Data analysis is very important. And I request probably we will have a seminar. In this session, we'll have somebody must be speaking how to write a high impact article. Very, very important. Writing a paper is an art. You have to organize your research properly. You have to logically present the data. You have to have a very good level of discussion. Then only you can really write a very good, publish a very good article. And I request all my students and faculty members read high-ranking journals like Nature, Science, Journal of American Society journals. When you read high-ranking journals, you get the power of critical thinking. It's very important. I would say read 1,000 times. Every day you must read high-ranking journals. Suppose you are working on nanoscience and nanotechnology. There are excellent high-ranking journals in nanoscience and nanotechnology. Daily, you must read new publications. And another important point, as Honorable Minister indicated, in your research, you have to adopt the philosophy of interdisciplinary, transdisciplinary, multidisciplinary, cross-disciplinary approach. Very, very important. Look at my own domain of nanoscience and nanotechnology. If you want to become a good nanoscientist, nanotechnologist, you should know chemistry. You should know physics. You should know biological sciences. You should know computer. You should have computational capability. Then only you can become a good nanotechnologist. So we have to break all the boundaries. We have to study all the subjects. So we have to adopt the philosophy of interdisciplinary approach, multidisciplinary approach, transdisciplinary approach in your research. Probably you must have read in the paper that Mahatma Gandhi University is publishing quite a lot. And if you look at our international track record, our national track record, we are doing extremely well. And the students are given excellent training how to write good articles. So I wish all the best for this this workshop. I request all the participants to be very active, interact with the speakers, understand the latest trends in publication and academic writing. As the Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, I will be extremely happy to provide you all the know-how, facilities, infrastructure. We have brilliant faculties in our campus. If anybody, if any student is interested to interact with us, we will be there to help you. I congratulate the organizers in formulating such an excellent 30 days workshop. I wish all the best and success. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring words. And now let us begin with the felicitations. Let me invite Smriti Mini G. Pillai, University Librarian, Mahatma Gandhi University Library, Kottayam, to address the gathering. Smriti Mini G. Pillai, please address the gathering.
Hey, ma'am.
Respected Chairperson Sri Chandrababu sir, respected Minister for Higher Education and Social Justice, Professor R. Bindu madam, respected Vice Chancellor, Professor Sabu Thomas sir, and other dignitaries who are attending the inaugural function of the International Workshop on Academic Writing. It is a proud moment as far as we are concerned to have inaugurated this international workshop by the Honorable Minister for Higher Education. Research is a continuous process which demands the constant dedication and hard work from the researcher and the mentor. Every researcher should aim at completing his research work with quality in a time-bound manner. Research is also a public-funded process, and the fruits of which should be beneficial to the society. This international workshop aims to equip the researchers with a few tools and means to help them to pursue their research effectively. We have been diligent in providing the best resource person in each area. I request the participants to make use of this workshop. I wish this program all success and congratulate Sri S. Jasimuddin and the team for organizing such a program. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now, let me invite Dr. Verghese C. Joshua, Principal of CMS College, Kottayam, to address the gathering.
Am I audible?
Right.
President of the function, Sri Chandrababu C., Executive Director of NIPM Thrissur, respected Dr. R. Bindu, Honorable Minister for Higher Education and Social Justice, Government of Kerala, respected Professor Dr. Sabu Thomas, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, respected principals, librarians, academicians, researchers, and participants of this 30-day workshop may also join this I'm glad to join this rare moment for so many reasons. I'm saying it's a rare moment because a number of institutions from Kerala, colleges, university, library, and institutions from industry, join hands to conduct this wonderful workshop on academic writing and communication skills and research methodology and reference management and academic publishing. Such a, in my academic experience, I never seen such a program join hands of it, or a huge participation of so many institutions. And I am expressing our sincere thanks from CMS College on behalf and giving us a chance to join this wonderful occasion. And I wish all success for this particular program and wish all the best for the participants. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now let me invite Dr. K.M. Nazir, Principal of Farooq College, Calicut, to address the gathering.
Nikita, please call another. He's not there. Please call the next person.
Okay, sir. Let me invite Dr. Anita Jose, Principal of Assumption College, Chengnasheri, to address the gathering.
Honorable Minister Dr. R. Bindu, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, Professor Sabu Thomas, Chandrababu sir, and all the other dignitaries present in today's meeting, all the participants. On behalf of Assumption College, I'm very happy to state that we could collaborate with the Lower NED Research Associates once again. The fourth time now we are collaborating with Lower NED for research-related international online workshops. This time it is added happiness that because nearly 22 colleges are there along with NIPMR and Mahatma Gandhi University. It gives immense pleasure and undue satisfaction when such quality initiatives are taken up with much enthusiasm. What is most mention worthy is the systematic and responsible way these workshops are being conducted and the faithful follow-ups taken up. The rich panel of experts is indeed greatly inspiring. The genuine and unmatched quality is really praiseworthy. I take this opportunity to very specially congratulate the hardworking coordinators behind this venture. Resource coordinator, Sri Jasimuddin S., librarian, St. Stephen's College, Uruwood. Coordinators, Srimadi Madhumida Rajendra Prasad, dietitian, NIPMR, Trishur. Srimadi Miniji Pillai, university librarian, MG University. Sri Raish Thomas, librarian, CMS College, Kottayam. Srimadi Shabna, TP, assistant professor and head. Department of Library and Information Sciences, Farooq College, Calicut. Reverend Father Tinju Tom, Librarian, Assumption College, Autonomous, Chengnasheri. Sri Jobin Jose, Librarian, Marian College, Kuttikanam. Dr. Anit Suman Jose, Librarian and Head of the Department of Library Science, St. Peter's College, Kolanjeri. Dr. Danya P., Librarian, Payanur College, Payanur. And special thanks to Sri Jinto Michael, Director, Lower NED Research Associates, NIPMR, MG University, and all the collaborating institutions. All the best and special prayers. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Now, let me invite Reverend Dr. Roy Abraham P., Principal of Marian College, Kuttikanam, to address the gathering.
Honorable Minister of Higher Education, Dr. R. Bindu, Dr. Sabu Thomas, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, primary organizers, NIPMR, and Lower and Ed Research Associates, and other collaborating institutions and organizers, participants. I made it very glad to say that this is a wonderful movement, a collaboration of many academic institutions of different levels. Universities are there, national institutes are there, colleges are there, publishing houses are there. So it's a collaboration of a lot of people. It's going to be a very successful initiative in the higher education scenario in Kerala. When it comes to research and publishing, we know there are tons of publications and research theses available in universities and probably in online method or in methods. However, much less is used or usable. Long back, I remember a jack. There were a few people traveling by balloon, hot balloon, and an unexpected wind took them away. And on the top of a hill, they found a few people and yelled from there, "Where are we?" Immediately, the people down there, they said, "You are exactly 45 feet above this level." Then immediately, the response came from the people in the balloon. They said, "Oh, you are researchers, isn't it?" "Yes," they said, and wondered, "Why? How did you understand we are researchers?" "Because the information which you gave is useless. It's of no use to us. Do wonderful researches, but not being used or not being or not usable. I wish that this 30-day workshop make a very useful contribution to useful researchers in academia across. It's an international workshop, so across globe. May this be a great success. I again and again congratulate all the organizers and painstakers behind this. Marian College salutes all of them. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. College Uravur to address the gathering.
Good afternoon, one and all. Honorable Minister of Higher Education, Dr. R. Bindu, esteemed Vice Chancellor of MG University, Professor Dr. Sabu Thomas, respected Executive Director of NIPMER, Sri Chandrasekhar Babu, Sri Jindu Michael, principals and librarians of the various collaborating colleges, librarian of MG University, dear participants, resource persons, my dear colleagues. On behalf of St. Stephen's College, Udavur, I am very happy and privileged to be part of the inaugural function of the 30 days online international workshop on academic writing, communication skills, research methodology, reference management, and academic publishing. Educational research always improves teaching learning process by empowering us to teach and lead more strategically and effectively. The research component of education allows for a broader educational experience whereby students are able to explore the effects of applying new thought process and critical thinking through study and testing using new technologies. Members of different collaborating colleges, librarians from the colleges, MG University, which associates with NIPMER and Laurent Ed Associates, provide a key support for teachers working in challenging environments and give a common platform to different higher education institutions to work together and publish their articles in respected journals. I wholeheartedly wish all success to this online 30-day long online workshop and also use this opportunity to congratulate NAPMER and all participating colleges and librarians, especially librarian of St. Stephen's College, Sri Jasimuddin S, for organizing this workshop. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Now, let me invite Dr. T.C. Thangachan, principal of St. Thomas College of Teacher Education, Pala, to address the gathering.
Most respected Minister for Higher Education, Dr. R. Bindu, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, Professor Sabu Thomas, all the dignitaries, delegates, and friends. So the major purpose of this online workshop is to create a culture, the culture of scientific search or research, the culture of creating something new, and the culture of disseminating the new things to all. That means the culture of research, create, and disseminate. That should be the result of this online international workshop. So this institution, St. Thomas College of Teacher Education, Pala, is one of the institutions in the way of publications, research, and scientific experiments. So developing the culture of thinking, developing the culture of writing, and developing the culture of publishing is the need of the hour. So the collegiality between the culture of thinking, writing, and publishing, that will be the result of this 30 days international workshop. On behalf of my college and St. Thomas College of Teacher Education, entire family, I wish this international workshop will help all the academicians, researchers, and students also to go for scientific research, disseminate the ideas, and scientifically prepared papers that can be published also. So thank you very much. Once again, congratulating all the organizers. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Let me invite Dr. Shaju Verghese, principal of St. Peter's College, Kolangiri, to address the gathering.
Good morning, everybody. Very respected Honorable Minister, respected Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, Chandrababu sir, Ajindo sir, other participants, other dignitaries of the program. I'm giving from St. Peter's College, Kolangiri, I'm giving all the best for this 30 days workshop and wishing you all the best. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Let me invite Dr. Shabir Azikbal, principal of Lizzie College of Allied Health Sciences, Cochin, to address the gathering.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Honorable Minister Dr. R. Bindu, Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Sabu Thomas, respected Sri Chandrababu sir, other respected people, HOD, participants, and teachers. On behalf of Lizzie College of Allied Health Sciences, Cochin, I feel very happy and privileged to attend and also facilitate this program. Thank you, organizers, for this opportunity. And I wish very all the best to all participants to have a good experience by attending this workshop in future. Thank you. All the best once again. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Let me invite Dr. Sheila Shenai, NA, principal of MOSC College of Nursing, Kolangiri, to address the gathering.
A very good afternoon to one and all. Most esteemed Dr. Bindu R, Minister of Higher Education and Social Welfare, Government of Kerala. Dr. Sabu Thomas, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University. Sri Chandrababu C, Executive Director in Charge, NIPMR. Sri Jinto Michael, Director, Lore and Eid, Reverend Father Tinju Tom, all other respected principals, speakers, dignitaries, and delegates. First of all, I would like to convey warm greetings from MOSC Medical Mission, Kolangiri. As already mentioned by all the dignitaries during their speech, there are occasions in our career wherein We have to write research articles, thesis, proposals, and so on. Readers often make judgments on how well supported your ideas and arguments are, and whether that support is valid, sufficient, and convincing. In these contexts, excellent writing skills is necessary to survive and excel in the academic pursuits. It is my strong conviction that this international workshop on academic writing, communication skill, reference management, and publishing will definitely help in academic achievement of the professional, teachers, and students of any discipline. MOIC Medical Mission is very happy to join hands in the organization of this great venture. I wish a happy learning to all the delegates and all the best for this collaborative venture. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now let me invite Dr. Annette Suman-Jones, librarian and head of the Department of Library and Information Science, St. Peter's College, Kolingeri, to address the gathering.
Jinder, please unmute Annette.
You can unmute. Okay, Annette.
Okay, Jindo, she couldn't unmute, please check. Say yeah.
Okay. I think she can unmute.
Gracie, in the fair Gracie, Nano. Hello. Either Gracie or Annette, please unmute.
Okay, it's Gracie.
Gracie unmuted.
Okay. Audible?
Yes, audible. Okay.
Honorable Higher Education Minister, Dr. R. Bindu, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sabu Thomas, and all the dignitaries who have felicitated during the event, and all the honored personalities who have joined this event. It is a great privilege to have the Honorable Minister of Higher Education herself to inaugurate today's seminar on academic publishing, which is one of the most relevant topics in the field of higher education. During our post-graduation period, we were not in a position to even dream about publishing a paper in any of the reputed journals. We had very few opportunities that time. But now things are changed a lot, and most of the degree students
from the colleges are publishing at least one paper during their course time. In this digital age, the possibilities are unlimited. But the more the opportunities, the more likely that mistakes will be made. The papers published in the past were few, but all of them were of good quality. According to the recent report, more than 50% of the papers published in India are of inferior quality. The aim of this certificate course is to create an awareness of this among the academic community of our students, teachers, and research scholars, and thereby producing quality publications that will be beneficial to the upliftment and development of our community. I pray to God Almighty for making this course a successful one, and I request everyone's wholehearted cooperation. And also, I'm taking this opportunity to congratulate all other collaborating institutions, especially the library professionals of these education institutions, and a special congratulation to our convener, Jasimuddin S. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. With that, we have arrived at the concluding part of the meeting. I would like to invite Smriti Gina Jain, librarian of the Cochin College, to propose the vote of thanks.
Honorable Minister for Higher Education and Social Justice, Dr. R. Bindu, MT University Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sabu Thomas, academicians, researchers, and friends, warm good afternoon. It's my pleasant task to propose the vote of thanks to this August gathering. And I would like to start off by extending our heartfelt gratitude to the Honorable Minister for Higher Education and Social Justice, Dr. R. Bindu, for charting out time from her busy schedule to grace our function. On behalf of NAPMR, MT University, Laurent Edge Research, and 20 other higher education institutions, I thank you, ma'am, wholeheartedly. Then, thanks are due to the Vice Chancellor of MT University, Dr. Sabu Thomas, for his presence and inspiring words. On behalf of our organizing team, I extend to you our warm gratitude, sir. Then I would like to thank Sri Chandrababu Ji, Executive Director in Charge, NAPMR, Thrissur, for his initiative and organizational skills. This workshop would have been possible without you, sir. Once again, thank you, sir. This gathering has benefited from the exceptional thoughts of wide variety of speakers. I thank each and every one of them for elevating the quality of the gathering. I also take this opportunity to thank Sri Jinto Michael, Director Lauren in Research Associate, for the welcome address. Then I thank Srimati Miniji Pillai, MG University Librarian in Charge, Dr. Verghese Joshua, Principal CMS College, Kottayam, Dr. Anita Jose, Principal Assumption College, Changanashiri, Father Dr. Roy Abraham, Principal Marian College, and Srimadi Lali K. Ziriak, Principal St. Stephen's College, Dr. T.C. Tangachin, Principal St. Thomas College of Teacher Education, Pala, Dr. Shaju Vughese, Principal St. Peter's College, Kalanjeri, Dr. Shabir Asikbal, Principal Lizzie College of Allied Health Science, Cochin, Dr. Sheila Shenai, N.A. Principal MOAC College of Nursing, Kalanjeri, Dr. Annette Suman-Jones, Librarian and Head of the Department of Library and Information Science, St. Peter's College, Kalanjeri, for felicitating the program. Once again, I am grateful to each and every participant for being a part of this event, and I extend to them a thank of full of joy Once again, thank you, one and all. Thank you all.
Jindo, let's wind up the program.
എന്തെങ്കിലും അനൗൺസ്മെന്റ് ഉണ്ടോ? നമുക്ക് പ്രോഗ്രാം അവസാനിപ്പിക്കുകയല്ലേ ജാസിൻ?
Participants, please note the schedule of the sessions will be shared today evening itself to the WhatsApp group you are joined. The sessions will be started from 23rd November onwards. So it's the let's wind up the function for now. Jindo.
Yes, sir. So the meeting is dismissed. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.